Hey guys, Brett Williams here. I want to show you a new plugin called Overlap that I've made available that will help you take your timeline from looking like a staircase like this to something like this. What I'm working on here is a slideshow, and I'm using the wonderful plugin from Stupid Raisins called Split Pop. It's a series of templates, each one with a bunch of drop zones, and each template has a build in and a build out. You can turn either one on or off. And the idea is that, you know, each one, you put it over the previous one, and it wipes on, you know, hiding the one before it. Let me highlight one. And you can see they also have the option to build out. So even if you were very diligent, you could do this more like in a checkerboard pattern with the top one building in and building out, maybe this one not building on at all. And at least it wouldn't take up a whole lot of screen real estate. But when your client calls and says, hey, I'd like these all to be 3 seconds instead of 5 seconds, of course you can highlight them all. Final Cut Pro is wonderful. Make them 3 seconds long. Okay, what is it? They're already 3 seconds long. All right, so they wanted them to be 2 seconds long. Control D, 2 point, and there we go. Okay, and now we have to go back in and we have to re-checkerboard them or, you know, re-staircase them. Or whatever it might be. So I came up with a better way because recently I was looking at a 13-minute personal project for an organization doing a little slideshow for them, and this was going to take forever. And just figuring out 3 seconds each, and then this one pans out. And a couple minutes in, I had a staircase that was just a scrolling nightmare. So what I came up with is a little plugin called Overlap. And what you're going to want to end up doing is go ahead and you want to build it like, you know, all in one timeline. And instead of doing the staircase, don't need that slug. First, let's make them all say 5 seconds. Control D, 5 seconds. Now I'm going to zoom back out with Shift Z. All right, so now we have all these little templates and they all just build in. Jump to the next one. This one actually has a build out because I was checkerboarding. Let's make sure they all just a build in. The inspector. And Split Pop is wonderful. It's got all these great little, you can either build in, build out. You can change the color of the little borders, you know, and their width. And each panel has a drop zone. You know, they all build in, they all automate on automatically. The idea being you overlap them. And there are other slides, this is pretty common, other slideshow plugins work the same way. But it can eat up a lot of screen real estate once you are working on a 13-minute slideshow. And of course you can compound them and things like that. But then you lose the ability to adjust. So came up with this little plugin. Let's select all of our templates. They're all set to a build-in. All I gotta do is double click on the plugin. It put one at the beginning and put one at the end. I don't need those. So now what I've done is within the transition here, the second clip is overlapping the first clip. Literally it does nothing except for that. And just jumping ahead to the next one. And occasionally you'll see that little bit of black there. Let me show you that again. You see that it didn't quite cover the background because the overlap transition that I put in there was shorter than the built-in animation on the incoming clip. So we can go to the index, search for BretFX. That's all of our transitions there. Click back over here. Now we can make them all a little bit longer. I'm going to make it a second and a half. And so now we shouldn't see that little. And there you have it. I say that a lot, don't I? Well, there you have it. As well now, if your client comes back and says, you know, I wish these were all 3 seconds, not 5 seconds. A pain in the butt with the checkerboard pattern. But once you've got them all in a single timeline, you can go over here and just look at this. See, they're all title effects. So select them all in the index, come back over to the timeline, Control D, 3 seconds. And now they're all 3 seconds. So very easy to not even worry about the duration of these sort of things. You just, you know, you can have your assistant put all the pictures in there. And then you come in and you tweak it and add the transition and you're done. We did add one extra little feature here. If, for example, the incoming clip doesn't cover the whole screen. Perhaps it's a logo that's building on or something and you want it over black, but you're still, maybe you're doing a whole bunch of them or something like that. You can fade out the outgoing clip. And you've got a little duration here. And so let's go put this back to that, what was it, 1 second? Where it wasn't long enough to cover. That also fixes this problem if you want. So the outgoing clip is fading away while the incoming clip is just cutting on and doing its standard build. So it's not that jarring cut to black around the edge there. And that would work the same way if you had a logo building in that didn't quite cover the screen. And there are some other little options here. You can actually create an asynchronous dissolve by offsetting when this fade out starts, and you have the ability for the incoming clip to fade in as well, and you can offset that too. So you could have the outgoing clip to start fading away right away, the incoming clip wait, you know, a little bit, and then it starts fading in. If you timed it just right, it would essentially be a dip to black, but you can kind of overlap those two dissolves. That gets a little more complicated, so just play with it. You can get this and more free plugins over at BretFX.com. Thanks for watching.